Video Killed the Radio Star presents the music videos of Elton John. In this episode, directors Russell Mulcahy and Marcus Nispel discuss working with Elton and why I'm Still Standing remains one of Elton's favourite videos, despite the mayhem caused during filming in the south of France.
Well, I've got this reputation of hating videos, or hating to make them. And I'm not fond of a lot of the videos that are made these days because it's just everything, it's just so formulaic.
I like I'm Still Standing because it was just so much fun to do. It was done under extremely tight circumstances because Russell Mulcahy, who did it, fell into the Mediterranean the night before with all the previous day's film. So it was really done in one day. It was good fun.
Just like ice, and there's a cold and lonely light that shines from you. You wind up like the wreck you hide behind that mask.
Yeah, there was sort of a script that was sent to France with some production manager down there. And then when we got there, nothing had been organised. And it was like, holy fuck, Elton's here, oh God. And she's going, what are we doing? And I love Elton. And I went, I have no idea what we're doing. Because everything hadn't been organised.
Don't you know I'm still standing better than
the producer of the time, God bless her, she's dead now. And this is serious. She had £10,000 in a brown paper basket, which she went and hid behind a bush outside the airport. And then came back to the hotel in Cannes. And so then said, oh, my money's been stolen. And then just the next day came back and the money, £10,000, was still behind the bush. I said, okay, look, give me the camera. Okay, so I'm got a leather jacket on and boots and heavy gear on, and I'm doing this handheld walking back on the pier, knowing exactly what I'm gonna do. And of course, I slip and fall in with the camera. The only thing, I remember surfacing and seeing the camera system dive in, not for me, because I was sinking, but coming up, I've got the camera. And I'm trying to slide this post, which is covered in moss, and sliding back underwater. Eventually they dragged me through the hotel lobby, looking like a wet rat. After I dried off, they managed to find another camera. Elton sort of, by that point, got the idea that there was a problem. We sat around and said, okay, you know what? Why don't we all just go down tomorrow morning and just film shit? And we just went down and had fun. Then we decided just to go out and paint some boys and girls, and Bruno there, who's now become quite a famous personality. I remember actually Bruno showing this video and on VH1 or MTV, and they would have little red arrows pointing to whenever there's Bruno again in the black. There's Bruno again. Bruno. And we just did shots like this and just had fun on the beach. It was the most fun video to shoot. Because at that point I realised you can just be creative on the spot if you need to be, or if you have to be.
I'm still standing.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. But it was so funny. I was watching Mamma Mia, or 20 minutes of it, it was like watching some of I'm Still Standing. You know, people popping up behind things and doing all that. But it was all invented on the spot. Duran Duran turned up and started handing out martinis. So now we're on martinis and everyone's getting very happy.
It was the first time I ever had a martini, thanks to Simon Le Bon. I got up at 5 o'clock in the morning to start shooting that video. By 7 o'clock, I was flagging, and Duran Duran were at the hotel and they said, oh, have a martini. I had like six in half an hour, and I ended up by destroying my room, beating up my poor manager, who then drove all the way to London in my car from Nice with clown's makeup on. And then that became my drink of choice. Thank you, Simon.
And that was after him smashing John Reed in the face. John Reed in clown makeup in a convertible Bentley, leaving France with blood streaming out of his face in clown makeup, saying, "I'm going back to London at 4 a.m. in the morning," and driving off. I was like, right.
But I think I'm Still Standing was a kind of a really excellent video. At that time, it changed a lot of videos.
I think I knew the Elton song was a gay song. I think what happened is it was the school that was misled where we shot it. It's one of the rare ones I did with Elton, one of the early ones I did, and he does not appear in the video. The concept was basically about hero worship. Unfortunately, what happened is it was misconstrued as being a very gay-themed video, which I suppose you can read into that. Unfortunately, what happened is that the school, I think, got the script, but then they didn't get the song at the same time. And when you combine the lyrics with the script, I guess you can read another story into it. If you only knew what I'm going through. So we shoot this film, and it's basically about a young boy, realism of an older prefect, and very much a Lindsay Anderson if type thing. Now that chap there is a man called Michael Baldwin, the teacher there. Michael did the wardrobe for many, many, many of my videos in the 80s. I remember one morning someone rang me up and said, "Have you seen the front page of the newspapers?" I went, "No," and they said, "Well, I think you should go buy it." And there it was on the front page as the major story of the day. Of this outrageous video. Russell Mulcahy corrupts 30 Boy Scouts. And how dare we do it? When it was actually just a very simple story of, you know, a young man's appreciation of an older guy, you know, of hero worship, basically.
Don't wish it away, don't look at it like it's forever.
Probably one of my favorite Elton songs. I think we maybe shot it over 2 days. Because I think the black and white stuff was shot on a separate day, and then all the interior nightclub stuff was the final stuff we shot. Till about 9 a.m. in the morning, having flown back from France, having shot till 5 a.m. in the morning, and basically no sleep. And I jumped on a plane and went and did my first feature film, Razorback, in Sydney. There's a certain sexuality in this. The song is incredibly sexual, like thunder. I guess it hit a chord with me. I think we paid each boy about an extra £10 to have his head shaved. Elton's songs, like Billy Joel songs, like Duran songs, lent themselves to telling a story, and they're inspiring to film. John Metcalf shot it, beautiful lighting, inspirations from West Side Story, inspirations from Greece, inspirations from my childhood. We had the Wallflower Girls at the school dances. When I shot this, it was a very personal recollection of my childhood to a degree. We wanted to have a retro hairpiece on Elton, and the lady who did the hairpiece did such a wonderful job on it that I think he slept in it for a week and then took her on his tour for about 4 years. And I guess that's why they call it the blues. We got on famously, and I think we did some very good work together. Some of these videos have held up or whatever is because no one, sometimes including myself, but no one around me knew what the hell I was doing. Or, I mean, there was no book.
Has a very almost like cathedral-like quality to it. Like in the age of sampling, you find it a lot because it's big, you know, it's a big sound. So I tried to come up with something that like counters it and or goes with that. And what I remember was some of the exterior shots in the movie Metropolis, where you see like these incredibly tall buildings, and it's almost like a silver city, and like in between there are like little biplanes and zeppelins cruising around, and that's like the underbelly of one of the Zeppelins.
I believe in love.
this one already has been going on for 3 months now, 2 months, 3 months, just because the good thing is they knew a long time ago they wanted to do it, so I started shooting already, pulled a lot of favors, started to work on special effects and miniatures. That doesn't mean I'm like lingering over their video every day, but it's with me. I think one of the disadvantages of this whole industry is they call you, they say we want to shoot tomorrow, you know, we want to shoot next week. It can only be as good as the prep is intensive.
Marcus has really shot my bit in this as a performer, which is good. I feel comfortable doing that. I mean, now I'm, you know, over my pre-video tantrum, which happens every time. It's been going great. He's very well organized. What he's explained to me, this should look fabulous. Should be about the best video I've ever done, I think.
The man likes it if things are together, and I like things to be together too. So we sync on that level, you know. When you go on a set, you want to get stuff done, and he takes direction incredibly well. Well, I don't tell him how to move, but I tell him what moves will work particularly well when, you know, like if you're very tight, you can do things with your hands you wouldn't be able to do in a wide shot. You would look like you're voguing, you know, but in a close-up it's okay. So I just like coach them a little bit, and it's almost like going to the dentist. You tell the dentist tells you roughly it's going to hurt now a little bit. This might be a slight moment of discomfort. The moment he tells you that, everything is fine. You don't tell that, it's not good.
I don't consider myself a video artist. I don't feel comfortable in the genre, really. It's like I hyperventilate before I come to do it, and then when I'm actually here and I'm doing it, I'm all right.
We're two different brands of musicians, so you strip with that in mind, but here in any case, you deal with such a classic, you know. You put him on a pedestal, you put him in a Zeppelin up in the sky, and that's all he needs to do. He just has to be himself. The merits of accomplishment.
When you see a great video like Fatboy Slim video with Weapon of Choice, you know, something different. I thought it's a very adult album I've made. I really want to ask people who don't normally make videos to do the videos for each single that comes out.
I want love, but it's impossible. A man like me, so irresponsible. A man like me is dead in places. Other men feel liberated, and I can't love shot full of holes.
So Sam Taylor-Wood, who's a dear friend and a great photographer, one of the greatest contemporary photographers and video installation artists. I asked her, would she do the video? She hadn't done one before. And she came up with a concept of doing it very simply, with not me. And I thought, that's great. I think anything sort of save me being in it. I came up with the idea of Robert Downey, which he loved. We contacted him, and it was all done, got together very quickly, within a week of the initial idea. I was in the south of France on holiday, and Sam was in LA shooting Robert Downey, and it worked brilliantly because the lyrics were so pertinent to what he's going through. I've been through that crap.
The rougher stuff, no sweet romance. A man like me.
places.
And it's worked. I mean, it's done an amazing job for this single, because in America it went straight on MTV. I haven't been played on MTV for 25 years. And everybody loved the simplicity and the fact that it was very stylish. And it was a mature video for a mature kind of song. So the following singles that come out, I'm hopefully going to get people, again, who to interpret what they think the song means. Whether I'm in them or not doesn't really matter to me. I prefer not to be in them. And that's why I think Fatboy Slim's pretty damn smart, even though he's quite a cute guy. But he's just, you know, I think I really admire his way of logic there.
I don't really like doing videos that much, but if they do click with a song, it really, and it, sometimes you can get a rare blend of song and video and it really works. But when you do get them to click, really, that really helps the song.